In this course, we are going to create and design a modern application with a professional backend. This course is going to be very detailed, covering each and every step, so you will be able to create your own applications once you complete this course. This course is designed in a way that it can be beneficial for beginners, mid-level coders, or a senior professional coders. So definitely, because we are going to cover each and every step, there are a lot of things that you will learn in this course. So first of all, let's quickly have a look what we are going to create. Let's run the application. So you can see the splash screen. Our design will be in both light and dark modes. So first of all, let's talk about the onboarding screen. You can see the animations. So we have three screens with a scrolling navigational dots at the bottom, and then we have the next button, and at the top you can see a skip button. Skip button is currently taking to the last screen. So when user is click on this button, he will be redirected to the login. In the login, we have email and password, remember me, and forget password button. So you can see a forget password screen, and on the submit, email will be sent to the user to reset his password using Firebase. Then in the create account, user can create his account using email, password with all the details required, and then he have to agree to privacy policy in terms of use. Once he click on the continue, we will verify his email, and once the email is verified, a successful screen will be appeared. After successful login using email and password, user can be able to log in to the application. And down below you can see we will also cover Google and Facebook authentications to let the user log in or create account. Let's go to the login, and this is the home screen, the main screen, in which first of all you can see at the bottom we have a navigation menu. We have four menus, and then the home screen is divided into two major parts. The one is in the blue and the other was in the white. So first of all, we have app bar with a cart icons. Then we have a search. Then we have scrolling categories. We have multiple categories that can be scrolled. Then we are going to design the banners, products, and again, we're going to learn how to create a grid. Product can be liked, added to wish list, or removed from the wish list. You can see the price tag, title, brand of the product. Products are going to be have two types. The first one is a simple product. Let's say we are going to open a simple product which don't have any variations. It has a simple one single price, $400, discounted price, tag, rating, title, subtitle, description, and at the bottom you can see we have reviews. You can add this product in the wish list, remove this, select any image, view any image in the last screen, and also you can add items to the cart, add to the bag, and you can see in here two items are added. You can also add items to the cart directly from here by adding a plus sign. This directly add to cart feature is only for the simple products, not for the variation product, because as you can see, this product has a variation. Price range can be seen over here. Let's open this product, and in here we cannot directly add from there because we have to select variation first. So let's select this variation. We have different colors of the product, and again we have different sizes. So based on each variation, we have different images at the top. You can see we can again view this image in large mode. We can add the product into favorites, price variation, variation stock status, and also definitely variation details can be seen over here, then in the description. Then also we have a reviews of the product. So each product have its own reviews. Then also we can add that simple variation. Let's say red 34. Add it into the cart, and you can see total we have two items. And let's go to the cart. At the top you can see we have the same product, the first one with a green 34, and at the bottom we have red 34. So the same product is added, but we have two different variations. And also you can add items in the cart. Checkout price is also being updated. Then let's go to the checkout. We have list of products, add a promo code over here. Total shipping fee, tax fee, and order details. You can change the payment method. Also, you can select any other address. You can also add a new address from here. So let's go back. So once the process is completed, user click on the checkout to complete this payment. We will show PayPal and some other payment methods. So once the payment API returns success state, so once the payment is completed, this screen will be appeared and user can be able to continue his shopping. Next, we are going to create a search bar with a bunch of other options. We have filter as well. After that, we can see we have categories. Each category have list of subcategories, and each subcategory has a list of products. So we're going to design two type of product designs. The one is this style, and the one you can see over here. Also in the subcategories, you can view all the subcategory products. You can sort them. You can add items to the cart. You can view variations right from here. Let's go back. Okay, next we have a store screen. Inside you can see again we have a reusable widget, app bar, reusable search widget. Then we have a new feature brands, in which we can view all the brands. We can open some brand, list of products of each brand is available. Then we have tab bar for each category, sports, furniture, electronics, clothes. And at the top you can see we have lots of lists. So let's come to the sports, and in here you can see we are displaying two feature brands, and each brand has top products in it. So you can also open the same brand as well. Down below you can see we have feature products of each category. After that we have wish list. We can add items in the wish list, remove items from the wish list, go to the product, add product to the cart, go to the profile. And in the profile you can see, first of all we can edit the profile, change name and other data. We have list of addresses. Same way we can add address to the database. Then we have a cart we have already seen. We can add items, we can remove items. Then in the orders you can see the state of the orders, shipping, processing, delivered, and we have a bunch of other options. So this is what we are going to learn in this course. This course is going to be very useful for everyone, so stay tuned. You can download the code of this course from the description below, or you can directly go to the Coding with T to download its code. Okay, the core concept that we are going to learn in this playlist, we will design a folder structure which will be expandable. You can create any type of large application. You can extend this application up to any level using the same folder structure, so it will be a professional as well as expandable. Then we are going to learn how to create light and dark themes. Reusable light and dark themes means we are going to create a folder. You can copy and paste that folder into any other application which requires light and dark modes, so it will definitely work. After that we are going to create definitely a modern and a minimal design. Then we will learn how to use Firebase authentication, Firebase Firestore, Firebase storage, GetX storage for the local storage, and GetX state management, and shared preferences or GetX storage for the local storage. Okay, now at the end let's talk about the playlist. The whole course is divided into 5 major sections. The first section is the app configuration. Then we are going to talk about the login design. This course is designed in a way that it is not directly linked with the e-commerce application. As you can see, app configuration videos is applicable for any type of Flutter application. Login design is applicable again for any application which requires login. Login backend is also for any type of application. Then in the e-commerce design and e-commerce backend is only related to the e-commerce. So let's talk about each in detail. So first of all, let's talk about the app configuration. The first is definitely we're going to create a project, and we are going to design expandable folder structure including pubspec, images, icons. Then the second video is about the themes in Flutter, light and dark modes. We are going to create a custom themes, reusable themes. And then we are going to learn how to create constants of colors, images, text, create helper functions, and some other utilities that we are going to require in our application. So these three things can be used in any type of application. Okay, now let's talk about the second section, which is the login design. Inside we are going to talk about splash screen, onboarding, three screens, login, sign up, and forget password with the reset password options. Okay, now let's talk about the main section, which is the third section, e-commerce app design. You can see we are going to cover a lot of videos in it, but as we will start creating the videos, we will also start creating custom widgets, and we only have to reuse those custom widgets and play with those widgets to create our designs in the next videos. Okay, at the first you can see we're going to create a bottom navigation which include 4 menus, then a curved design which is again going to be a challenge. Then we're going to create a custom app bar which is going to be used in throughout the application. Then we have to design the categories, search bar, banners with the sliding dots, and definitely a product with a grid. After that, for the store section or the store page, we're going to create tabs first, and then with the featured brands or a button in which user will be able to view all the brands. After that we have category content with the brand section. After that we have wishlist, setting page, and profile page. So once completed, this next part, the product details, is going to be very useful, and definitely it has some tricky parts. So I suggest you to watch these videos in detail. I have divided this product details into 2 parts. The first part is about how we can add images, make the images selectable, view the image in the large mode, and show the selected image. After that we have text, price, show sale price, and also show the percentage, how much discount we have on that product, show the stock status of that product, and after that we are going to talk about, in the part 2, variations of product details, how to select the product variation based on each attribute, and also we're going to show the product details of each variation. Then we have cart, in which we're going to add the products, addresses, checkout and orders page. And at the end, we're going to design category details, view all products page and brands page. Then as a backend, we're going to cover this backend in detail, because those who watched the previous login tutorial, it was only for the beginners. So in this, we are going to cover each and every step to make it professional application. So first of all, we are going to definitely set up the Firebase. Then we are going to use the local storage to store the onboarding state. You can store it in the Firestore. Then we have a registration screen. We use email and password authentication, Google sign in, Facebook sign in, and also forget password to send emails. Then in the last section, for the e-commerce background, we are going to first fetch the categories and brands. Then we are going to fetch the products. We are going to display all the products. To overcome the issue of reads and writes in the Firestore, you will learn that how we can avoid maximum reads and writes and only fetch the product once. So definitely there are going to be multiple things that you will be able to learn at the end, so don't miss this last section. Then we are going to learn how to add items to the cart from outside the product, inside the product details, either it's a single product or it's a product variation, show the total count of all the products, add items to the favorites, show the addresses, checkout, and definitely orders when the orders are being placed. So this is what we are going to create in this playlist. So once again, if you are interested in the complete code, you can get that code from the Coding with T, or you can get the link from the description below. If you have any questions, don't forget to ask me down below in the comments. Stay tuned, don't forget to subscribe to get notified about each upcoming video. Thank you for watching. Take care. Allah Hafiz.